Welcome back to the 13th episode of Real College Reviews. Can't believe the season's almost over, but before it is, I have a really special guest today. It's none other than my cousin, Peter. Peter, could you introduce yourself for the audience a little bit?
Hi, my name's Peter Nazzaro. I am a junior and I go to Kean University, and my major is business management.
Awesome, and we'll just jump right into it like I always do with how you chose your college. Kean University, for you and for me as well, because we don't live too far away in Jersey. It's a local school. When you're looking at schools, were they all kind of local, or, you know, did you just, or were they some of them far away? I mean, what was just your process of deciding on Kean?
Well, actually, the only two colleges I applied for were Kean and Montclair.
Oh, so you, that's the only places you, wow.
That was the only places I applied for, not even Rutgers. And it was mainly because I didn't have a car at the time.
Right.
So it's, you could, the train station, the Union Station is right there. It's like four stops away.
Okay.
So that's what I would take over the weekends to go to work so I could keep my job and visit home without any worries.
Right.
And just the tuition was a little bit lower than Montclair. So in the end, it would just be pretty much for saving money.
Right. And I guess you only applied to two schools. Were you looking at any schools, or was it just Montclair and Kean?
It was really just Montclair and Kean. Montclair was more just like, I need a second option. I'll have a second option.
Right, right.
And also, my older sister, Sophia, goes to Kean, too. So mm-hmm. I was like, hey, she'll be here as well.
Yeah.
You know, why not? And she likes it, so.
Yeah, well, you know, you'll probably like it as well. Right. I get the thought process 100%. I just know I'm a polar opposite. I applied to 20 schools. I did not know what I wanted. But I definitely kind of wish I was like you, where it was like, all right, one or two options. There's a 50% chance I go to each school. But yeah. It is what it is. We're all different. But you mentioned the tuition and the proximity to home and the train station. Were there any other specific draws that Kean brought to the table, or was it really those two that were the main factors?
I knew I wanted to be I knew I wanted to do business management as my major, which, so I didn't go in undecided.
Okay.
I don't know if you'll talk about that later.
Yeah,
but,
yeah. We'll definitely jump into it later on.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I had heard from other people just talking about it that Kean is a good business school, mm-hmm. or, you know, good enough for what it is.
Right.
I think it's good enough. So I guess that was the only other thing leading up to it.
Yeah, and it makes sense. I think those are definitely the three most important things when deciding a college.
Right.
Cost, proximity to home, and then obviously the education
major,
you're getting.
Right.
And like you said, we'll definitely jump into, you know, your major and what work you do, you know, later on in the episode, but kind of perfectly segueing into the next kind of thing I want to talk about is the quality of classes. And you said for the most part, you alluded to that it's a good school.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of the coursework from your senior year of high school to your freshman year of college, some people say that transition's easy. Some people say it's challenging. I mean, what was your experience with that?
Right. So I think a combination of it is the courses you take, because the beginning of wherever you go, I think for the most part,
right.
it's just the basic, you need the generic class. Exactly.
Yeah.
So those, I would say, are pretty easy for the most part, regardless of, you know, how well it compares to
what they have
high
you
school.
Taken, like science classes and like humanities.
What did I take? All I can remember right now is like psychology, my
so
first
like
semester.
Random stuff that had nothing to do with business.
I just needed and I had to take a basic math class.
Then, okay.
And I might have taken like one, they were all like introductory things.
Right,
I think there was like one or two, maybe two bits specifically other than GE classes, but yeah, for the most part, I think that was that.
Yeah, and it was just, like you said, pretty easy to transition from one to the other.
So high school, at least compared to that, was significantly harder.
Really?
Yes, I got, compared to that, I don't know why, but I feel like I did better in college than I did in high school, at least my first year. I mean, I would get like the first 2 years, I would get like A's, B's, and like C's.
Right.
Like, it would be the wide range. It actually wasn't until last semester, which is why I don't know if it's just I've gotten better at it, and I don't want to jinx myself.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I'm just getting better at it, or it's just the courses are different. But last semester I got like 5 A's and a C. So
there we go.
Yeah. Well, maybe. Maybe, I don't know. I just hope I keep it up. But
right.
I know the course load, at least. I know my fall of last year, so about a year ago
yeah,
now,
yeah.
I took, oh no, I'm sorry, this past spring. So
yeah.
I keep forgetting when I took it. I took 5 in-person classes, mm-hmm. and then I took one virtual online class. So it was 19 credits.
Wow, that's a big...
And then my... I'm trying to do that again this semester.
With the 19 credits?
It's 18. Because,
but same, 6 classes. But
yeah, 6 yeah. classes. The only thing is with Kean, because I am not a Kean online student, mm-hmm. I am just a regular Kean student. Right. And go physically in person, if you want to take virtual classes, you have to wait until like 5 days or like a week the semester begins. So I was able to get into that virtual class.
But it's not a guarantee.
It's not, because you're not considered like that.
Right.
I can do a waitlist. I think I wound up, I had a, it was an accounting class, and oh boy, I don't like accounting, but.
It's definitely challenging.
Yeah. I had one as, I don't know if someone else would want to take 19 credits, but I had one as physical in-person one on a wait list as my backup, and then I had the virtual one. I believe it was also on a wait list on my backup.
Gotcha.
So currently now, I think I checked a couple of days ago, there's like 6 seats open, but we have till the end of the month anyway, so hopefully I can get in. But.
Yeah. Hopefully it does happen. And looking at the class sizes, at least when you're in person, because virtually it doesn't matter. I just looked it up. Kean, slightly under 11,000 undergraduate students. So it's kind of like a medium-sized school. Your classes, were they large, small, in the middle? I mean, how many students are you looking at in a typical Kean class?
So for smaller, or for like more specific classes, there's like the 2 types of classes. There's just the regular, just class, just I don't know how to
gen
describe it, just classes
of, yeah,
or not even those, just if it's more specific, I guess, mm-hmm. they'll have, I don't know, it's about 30 people,
so like a high school, larger high school size class.
Yeah. And then there'll also be like, I know some days I would have like a 2 normal days, mm-hmm. where it would be like 30 people, and then there would be a day where it's a lecture and it was like several hundred.
Yeah.
So for the most part, though, like almost all of them are all just the 30 around there.
Yeah.
It can vary, and I'm sure it will probably get lower the less or the more specific
you
it
get.
Gets to the major.
100%. That's very typical at all schools, not just Kean, not just state schools, not just schools with 10,000, 11,000 students like Kean does have. But looking at the professors, you know, you probably get a mixed bag, I would assume, with a state school. But for the most part, you know, were they good? Were they bad? And then something that students oftentimes kind of underestimate, were they accessible in terms of emails and going to them for extra help?
Right. I'll start with, like, the quality, I guess.
Yeah, for sure.
Some were excellent. I love going to their classes. Even if, like, I had some professors that were like, I don't want to see your phone at all. It's just us for 3 hours.
Right.
You know, I would actually look forward to those classes because I liked the professor a lot and how he spoke and how he would go off on tangents that were related to what the class was about, though. It was a philosophy class.
Those are always fun.
It was actually a great
class.
Those
are always fun.
But then there would also be like, I've had 2 or 3 classes now where my professor wouldn't put in my grades.
Oh, those are the
and
worst.
I had to retake a English class because it was spring
2023.
Thank
our
you.
Our freshman year.
I'm forgetting.
No,
when.
It's a lot. It's a lot. Yeah.
Spring 23. I took a English class. The professor, I would ask, I should have done it earlier, but I would ask like, you know, what my grade is, because she didn't put it in, and she would just say during the class, like, I know people are asking for grades, but like, you're probably fine, more or less. And
well,
then
that's so reassuring.
I think I didn't do well on one of the assignments, and I've eventually like I think 3 days before the final.
Yeah.
And I found out what my grade was, and I dropped the class right before.
Wow.
So I had a WF, withdrawn fail.
Yeah. And that's why I had to retake it.
And that's why I retook it. And now it's overridden, I believe, as an A.
Yeah.
So that works.
It worked out.
And that's completely on the professor, because I think there were 3 or 4 people in that new English class, which I took spring 24.
That had
so
that
I,
professor?
That had the same.
Wow.
They were in the same exact class as me. So, and that professor was, I mean, you know, it was, you know, I would, you know, zone out and
you just wouldn't pay attention.
I wouldn't really, I'm not really one to fall asleep in class, but
get close,
you could say that. but I was able to go after class and ask, you know, hey, how's, you know, I think I turned this in, you know, can you update my grade right. on it? Or I don't, any like little question about like, oh, like just confirming we don't have class this day because yeah. you have something else. I've had, in that case, those professors were great. Right. So it was the same course, two very different professors.
Yeah.
And I had a withdrawn fail. And if I didn't withdraw, I would have had an F.
Right.
Or an A, you know?
So it's definitely a mixed bag, like you're saying. And yeah. even in my experience, it's 100%, not 100%, but largely it's dependent upon the professor and the course time as well.
I would give it more the benefit of the doubt, though, because it's pretty uncommon to have a super not great professor.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'll have it like once a year, maybe at this point.
It's like one out of 10, 11 classes are just a professor that's not.
Yeah. They'll all, for the most part, respond to like emails. So that really wasn't
an issue.
I think for the most part, that wasn't an issue.
Yeah.
And I'll actually, I don't know if all professors, I don't think all professors do it, but, or how other colleges do it.
Right.
But I've had professors make their own calendar about the days we're meeting, because there were some days that she couldn't meet because
yeah.
we met three times a week. That was the four, that was a four credit
right.
class. And she, it was from the beginning of the semester to the end with all of the dates. And she's like, I'll let you know if it changes and I'll update it. But that's good to know so that
you
I don't
plan.
Show up to class and be like, oh,
where's everyone? Yeah, I've done that before. It's not fun.
Yeah.
And looking more towards students at Kean University, you know, it's a big school and there's a lot of students, so it might be kind of hard to generalize, but what's the typical student at Kean like? I mean, what characteristics do they have? You know, what are you expecting to see walking around campus?
Kean is full of a lot of commuters. I believe it's mostly commuters. And I mean, from what I can tell, they're mostly just like people who just want to just get their work done.
Right.
The library is always, I mean, especially during finals time, but even when it's not, there's a lot of people there. I mean, it helps that there's a Starbucks in the library.
Right.
So.
That you can just, yeah.
Right. And I mean, you know, there's Kean has loads of events, and I'm sure you'll get to that later.
Right.
But, you know, they tend to have a good following and everything, so I wouldn't say that every Kean student is, like, bad or anything.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's some bias there, but...
It's just a commuter school. People kind of come in for class and then, you know, want to get out, either to have work or, you know, want to get back home
right.
for dinner or this, that, and the third.
So, for the most part, I would say, by get out, that could either be they need to get out for work or they just want to leave. Because I had a class where this girl was like, oh, yeah, and she was comparing stuff of her, like, managing experience to one of our classes
right.
we were going over. So in some cases, it's useful
right.
from what other students experience mm-hmm. from their firsthand work experience as well.
Yeah.
So
it's an interesting way
yeah.
to look at it. And I just looked it up, too. 85% of Kean students drive in for class and 15% live on campus. So you're definitely right. It's a majority commuter school, which I want to definitely talk about later on. But looking more towards the campus, I know it's in Union. I don't know much else about Kean University. I mean, is there anything special about the campus? Is it pretty? I mean, just give me the rundown of what I see walking around at Kean.
It's very scenic, I can say that. I have lived there for the past 2 years, so I don't know if this would be different if you were a commuter, but almost every single day there's some kind of landscaping going on. I don't know if this is right, but I've heard they spend over $1 billion on flowers a
wow.
year. I don't know if that's accurate or not, but it checks out because they're always on top of like leaf blowing and lawn mowing and just making the campus look pretty because they take lots of photos. And even when it's like winter, they'll like, instead of they'll just being dead plants, they'll like just remove them, you know?
Like, so they're always making it look nice.
Yeah. And I feel bad for I don't feel bad for them because I'm sure they're getting paid well for it.
Right.
But, you know, they'll do it like freezing temperatures to
yeah.
really hot days, and they do it. I'm sorry. What else was there?
No. I was going to ask you the next thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
Was just going to be, right, I have 5 minutes, for whatever reason, I got 5 minutes to walk around Kean. What's one building? What's one part of campus that I got to see that I can't miss?
I would say the main part of the campus is you'll see it first, but it's not a building. It's like what people call the clock tower. It's literally just a tower with a clock on it.
Like in Tilted Towers.
Sure.
I'm kidding.
That's a comparison. And next to it is the student center, where they always have loads of events going on. I'm a part of a fraternity, so we'll host like bake sales and other events there, and plenty of other organizations will do that too. And I mean, that's always a lot. And you can like sit there and study. You can get food there. It's not as quiet as the library, but obviously, if you wanted to, I mean, you could print stuff out there. You can ask. There's Kean employees there who you can ask for help.
Right.
So I tend to be there a lot too.
Yeah.
So
it definitely sounds like a good student center, a good place to get work done or just talk to people, you know, whatever it might be. And you mentioned that you lived on campus for your first 2 years. The dorm rooms, at least physically, I mean, what is it, like a typical dorm room, would you say? Or, I mean, what is it like?
So my freshman year, I actually lived in the newest and nicest dorm, which I don't know how this compares to other colleges, but you didn't have a key you needed to put in. You would just tap your card.
Like, wow, that's nuts. That's fancy.
It had this massive like kitchen living area, and you were able to have it, and it had AC.
Oh, so that's a bonus as well.
And I think you were able to change the AC based on each room. So I don't know if you know how Kean does it. It's in a room. It's a suite. So there's two rooms, or there's technically three rooms. There's the living kitchen area.
Right.
And then there's like an A and a B. And dorm, in each of those, then there's the two.
Gotcha.
So there's four people.
And that's every dorm room, or is that just the one that you were in?
Almost everyone. I think you can apply for singles if you want.
Right.
But I've never done that. And it's double the cost. So...
I didn't
do that. And so I actually went from the most expensive dorm my freshman year to last year, my sophomore year, to the cheapest dorm.
And how did that compare?
I believe it was built in the 60s or the 70s. Oh. And well, you know, it's shown some age. I think the first day or two that the AC, which wasn't actually AC, is just like a fan
that
blows.
Right. Yeah.
It's air cooling. If you go on Kean's website, it's called air cooling. The newer buildings, there's another one, have air conditioning, but that doesn't. It wasn't working initially. The resident assistant was like, you know, if you're anything in your room isn't working, file this and someone will get it as soon as possible. And like within days it was fixed. And you know, maybe it was uncomfortable the first night or two, but like.
But after that, it worked.
The service
out.
Is generally pretty good in terms of like maintenance.
Right.
I mean, I did have our shower would clog and then the water would go up significantly. It did go down, but. And it's not like it spilled over into the floor.
Right.
But it
was just
would,
annoying.
It would just stand. And eventually someone came too, but. Yeah, those dorms, which they call the quads, there's four of the same exact building that they made around the same time period, 60s, 70s, whenever they did it.
Yeah.
That is a... it's the same, like, kitchen living area thing, and then two other rooms. I will say the bathroom is tiny compared to
the newer ones.
The newer ones.
Yeah.
But the newer ones, you can literally fit, like... probably 25 people inside.
Oh, so it's a big bathroom and you're
right.
Going to like a
normal
size.
So, and then you're going
one.
To like a, well, I would say for a house, it's pretty small anyway, but you really don't need to have more than one person in the bathroom anyway. So it's okay. I didn't mind. The only like quality difference I wasn't crazy about was and this is just preference, I guess.
Right.
The floor was just tiled instead of like a carpet. And I was like, this just feels like a school.
Right. Like you're walking in a high school.
It felt like an industrial building.
Yeah.
But other than that, like the cabinets worked. I mean, they were fine. Nothing was like falling apart or anything.
Right. And even then the tile, it's not that big of a quality. Like it's a very minor thing.
Yeah, I feel like that's more personal preference.
Right.
And there are other buildings that do have it, so I wouldn't say that's like turn off from that.
Yeah. for sure.
I mean, the windows opened. I mean,
so it all worked. And I know you lived.
It worked,
yeah. I know you lived in the quad your sophomore, like you were just talking about. Mm-hmm. But, and I know a lot of students are commuters as well, like we talked about, 85%. But looking at housing options, if you want to live on campus or at least around the school and not commute, you know, what are your housing options past your freshman year? Do most students go to a house or an apartment in Union their junior, senior year? I mean, you know, what does that seem like?
Right. So I know Montclair, I believe, has off-campus housing. Kane doesn't have any.
Okay.
So
it's all
whatever
like dorm rooms on campus.
Right.
Okay.
So whatever's on the campus is what there is. Okay. I don't know anything about other people renting off campus
right.
to go there. I would say mainly in part that either I don't talk to enough people to find that out, and that you said 85% of
yeah.
them are commuters, so it probably just isn't like necessary for them to just, you know, if they live
right,
close enough
those.
to commute, they probably don't need to.
Right.
Other than that, I think that was it.
Right. Yeah. And I think that's pretty typical for, you know, majority commuter school. And something I got to ask that kind of goes off of that is obviously it's commuter school. So 85% of the students are going to be from New Jersey, but that 15%, are they mostly from New Jersey as well? I mean, have you met anyone from out of state?
One of my suite mates was from New York, and I think one of my sister's roommates or someone new was, I think, like Delaware.
Okay.
Or maybe like somewhere in like the Northeast.
Yeah, like Connecticut
one
or
of
somewhere
those
like
states.
That. Right.
I can't remember off the top of my head, but it was, you know, no one I don't think is really coming, you know, far and wide just to, you know, the whole reason, you know, at least I was attracted to me was
right.
because of the price.
Right.
And
right.
once you account for out of state housing,
it jumps up. Yeah.
I would say that's for the most part, that's where it come from.
Yeah, it makes total sense. And I know Montclair's the same way, Stockton's the same way. Even Monmouth, which is private, it's still mostly New Jersey people. But moving on to something that always connects to the dorm rooms and living on campus, and that's the dining halls. I've heard mixed things from every college, especially state schools. It's definitely a mixed bag. You know, I mean, the first thing I'll ask is just, did you like the food?
Well, I think you know that I'll eat pretty much everything.
Right, right.
I'll it's good enough.
Okay.
It's good enough. They like to be inclusive, I guess. They'll
like vegan and vegetarian
right,
stuff.
I feel more so like they're required to.
Yeah, I
and not
I think
they
at this
put effort
point,
into it.
Yeah.
So they, I mean, I could tell you, I could say past Kane and like my experience and then like what it is now, I guess.
Yeah, if there's been a change, then yeah.
I feel like it changes every semester, and who knows what it's going to be this fall.
I was going to say, Shia, what was it like when you first were on campus as a freshman?
So it was just like they have like screens above that just says what they are.
Okay.
And, oh wait, no, this was before that. I'm sorry. They would have like these little paper like boards that would just say what it is, and
yeah.
I think how many calories or something like that.
Interesting.
And then... And they would just change it out. I think breakfast ended at like 10 or something.
11
like,
or something like
around
that.
There.
Right.
And then they would just swap it out. And if you wanted like, and they had like one of those like big signs you would put on the road.
Right.
Or like on like a sidewalk
thing.
That would, you know, they would just say like what kind of burgers or whatever you would want.
Yeah.
And then you would just walk up and ask for the burger and they would make it.
Right. And was it a buffet, like, unlimited style, or did you have to pay
Once you pay, you're in.
So you could go back and get, like, five burgers if you
exactly.
really wanted.
There's only
okay.
one entrance. Once you make it through that, you have to pay somehow.
Right.
Once you make it through that, though, it's there.
Got it.
I don't remember the prices exactly, but breakfast, I think, is, like, $2 cheaper than lunch and dinner.
That's how it usually is, yeah. And did you have the unlimited plan, or did you just pay whenever you went into the dining hall?
The first year, I think I had the unlimited plan. The thing is, you can't gift, like, if like, of course, I have people who commute. I have friends who commute. You can't give that to people who commute.
Okay.
Or at least they changed that my sophomore year, I believe.
Okay.
So I just switched to the 14 meals a week.
Okay. So two meals a day.
So
yeah.
2 meals a day, you know, but sometimes I would like, they have like an app that you can use for other meals too that don't have to be the dining hall.
Right.
And it uses the meal swipe as in quotations, as a currency.
Yeah.
So you don't have to do it at the dining hall too. Some of them are terrible deals. Some of them are great deals. You can get a full-size Jersey Mike's cheesesteak for one meal swipe.
Oh, that's a really good deal. Yeah.
And then you can get like, I don't know, like...
like a drink at Starbucks for one meal swipe or something like
Starbucks
that.
Doesn't even support it, actually.
Oh, gee, they're too good for it.
I don't know, but they're that's like one of the best things.
Yeah.
Well, and then going back to the dining hall, my sophomore year, so last year, they added... or at some point around then, they added a screen, like a kiosk in the middle, and you put it in, and there's a queue system.
Wow, okay. So they got fancy.
Yeah, and they put, like, screens on top of all the food things. And just because there's screens doesn't mean it's good, because all of the cooks, I feel like they weren't trained to put up with that.
Yeah.
Because I wanted a burger, I waited... before it would take like 20 minutes,
right?
Which sounds like a long time, but that's kind of average there. I mean, I've gotten record low times before because they just cooked them all off. And,
right, it makes sense.
I've got it in like a minute before.
Okay,
but when they started rolling that out for like the first week or two, it was just, like,
how long did it take?
Hour and a half.
That's insane.
I've got up to 2 hours just for this
waiting for a burger.
Yeah.
Did you miss class? Like, how'd that?
No, because I was just wanting dinner. I was like, all right. And then I would just snack on things, and I was like, I'm not hungry anymore.
Yeah.
And then people would leave because there's no way to cancel the order. They would just keep making the food, and also people can just steal, like, they keep it in like a warmer or whatever.
And you just
go
in and
but
take
people
it.
Can just take it. I don't steal people's food, but I've had it where like they're like, oh yeah, we just like never made it. Or like also just like, I made it, where is it?
Yeah.
And I'm like,
has it gotten better at least? Like as sophomore year went along?
Right. Yeah, it's gotten a lot better.
Okay, that's good.
But I would eat around like 5:45 compared to when like the football team or something would get out. So it would usually get really busy at like 7 or 8.
Okay.
And that's when it would be packed.
And you just kind of have to avoid it at that point.
Yeah. Like even if you wanted to go back for like to see whatever the food was of the day, even if you wanted to go back for like seconds or something, it might not be there depending on how busy it is. I know some things they always have pizza. They always have burgers.
Makes sense. Chicken fingers or no?
Yep, chicken fingers and fries. And then the main things always rotate. And
like
then they also
like...
have like a specialty, like, I don't know what you would call it. Like, but it changes about every day.
Okay. So there's some variety within, you know, what you could get.
It doesn't have to only be what is there.
Gotcha.
Like sometimes it's like... stir fry, which is great.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's like chicken wraps, and it's like two chicken tenders and lettuce and like a tomato.
So like with the professors, it's a mixed bag.
Yeah. And in that part they're not different. They're different people cooking it, but it's the same company that's
providing the food.
Right. So, you know, knowing how fast it's changed in the past couple semesters,
it could just change when you get back.
Yeah, we'll see. But, you know, I would say overall the quality of the food, it's good enough for me.
Right. And in terms of other places to eat around campus, you know, is there like a Chipotle? I know you said Jersey Mike's. Like other places to eat that aren't the dining hall around campus?
Yeah, there is. I actually pass it to get to the business building because that's where I have to go.
Okay.
I actually work there. That does not accept meal swipes either. Most of the businesses around there don't. But I mean, yeah, there's two Starbucks actually. There's one by the Chipotle and then there's one on the campus.
Okay.
Yeah, there's the Chipotle, there's a Smash Burger that's on campus. But then there's other names you've never heard of before. But
there's other stuff that's not a dining hall.
Yeah, there's like Chinese food. There's like wannabe Chipotle that's on there. Oh, that's a great deal too. That's the other great
deal. With the
deal.
Meal swipes?
Yeah, because you'll get like, if you get like it's like the bowl equivalent, but instead of it being like the little Chipotle bowl,
right,
it's like a 9x9 takeout box and with
just
like
filled to the brim with
filled
stuff.
With, yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
Now, they used to, my freshman year, they had a pasta place, and being Italian, I didn't discover it until like the last week or two, and I was like, this is amazing because I'm Italian, but they got rid of it, and I was like, and I think they sent a form out at some point over this summer, and it was like, what food options would you be interested in? Mm-hmm. I forget if I filled that out or not, but hopefully people said Italian food,
yeah.
Because, you know, just the plain pizza was not, like,
me. It's not great, especially compared to Jersey pizza, too. And moving away from the dining hall, I just want to touch on it,
sure.
on Kean, rather, being, you know, more of a commuter school, rather. In terms of the weekends, right, your Friday, Saturday, Sunday, is campus kind of dead because everyone's home? Okay.
It's very much dead. Once it's Friday, it is... Yeah, it's gone. I would say, I feel like most people go out on Thursdays.
Like
I'll always see like people like dressed up and or coming back really late on Thursdays. I don't know why Thursdays.
I guess because they go home Friday. Yeah, I know it's big at other schools too.
That's probably because no one does anything at Kean.
Yeah,
they'll be. Like, people will go to either NJIT or Rutgers.
Interesting. Okay.
That's where people will go for parties. I don't go there because I don't go there. I mean, for parties, at least. I don't go there. But, it's pretty...
It's desolate on the weekends.
Now, granted, I work on the weekends.
Yeah.
So, like, I would take the first train, and it would be at, like, I don't know, like, I would like, walk through the campus at, like, 7:30 in the morning.
Oh, so, yeah, no one's going to be up no matter where you are.
And then
I'd
get back at, like, 4-something or 5.
Right.
And the most populated area I would find is, like, the dining hall.
Makes sense, yeah.
But that's mostly, like, people don't want to come out of their, like,
unless they need to eat. Yeah. It makes sense. Yeah. And that's actually what I wanted to ask you about next in terms of having a job while you're at college, because a lot of students now, right, I'd say it's a split where students work on campus or maybe they, like you do, kind of go home for the weekend and work and come back. I mean, what's that like juggling schoolwork, your college coursework, and then having a job as well?
Well, I don't know. It's more of like a change of scenery that keeps me going. This, and I'm doing it again before now where I have two jobs. So I would... When I did work at the Chipotle, I had Fridays off,
okay.
And I would work there. I worked there full time and throughout the summer last year.
Mm-hmm.
But once I was working there one day, and I wasn't crazy about working there anyway.
Yeah,
so,
it seemed like the most fun place.
So I was like, I told them I wasn't. I was like, I need to focus on my studies more, which was true, but also...
You just wanted to get the fuck out of there.
Yeah, pretty much. But I still kept up with my other job. And, you know, I make and I'm weird and I like being organized too much, but I have... Do you know what Notion is?
No.
Okay, it's an app I use, but it's for like... planning, and you could take notes in it or calendar or whatever.
Like organization purposes.
Right. So at the beginning of the semester, whenever I'll get the syllabus or whatever, I'll put in every single event from every single thing.
I have friends that do that too.
Put the due date on everything. Put if it's like a homework, a project, an exam, what the date is, what the course is.
Yeah.
And then I'll sort it by, you know, newest due date first, and then I'll have... three statuses. I'll have not started, in progress, and done.
Right.
And I try my best to do that as many as I could do in those chunks,
mm-hmm.
just to get them done so that I wouldn't have to worry about like whatever other commitments I had.
Yeah. And so, and I got to start doing that too. Cause it'll be the middle of the semester. I'll go scrambling. Like when's this essay due? When's this, that due? And it's, sometimes it gets a bit overwhelming, so I know friends that do that with assignments, and they'll write them all down with the due dates.
It's less that, like, I don't trust the professors with their syllabus. It's more that if I put it in to my one database that I created and I know, as long as I put it in correctly the first time, it's all there.
And looking at stuff to do outside of the classroom that's not work and not studying... Are there clubs or societies or, you know, whatever else that students are involved in, maybe not yourself, but that are just popular among Kean University's campus?
Yeah, they'll always have, like I said, in the student center, they'll be just random clubs and events I have never heard of before. And they'll have like fundraisers or just anything. You might be able to get stuff for free there.
Yeah.
Just to spread publicity of whatever it is. I mean, I don't... instead of like naming specific ones, I'm just going to say there's just a lot.
Yeah. So there's options to do if you want to get involved.
Clubs, organizations, there's a lot.
And I know you're part of a fraternity. Mm-hmm. Greek life as a whole at Kean, is it big there? I assume it's not like an Alabama or a Tennessee or somewhere down south where it's just their way of life. But you know, what's the Greek life scene at Kean, and what's been your experience
with
it?
You know, compared to like what other... I was told, compared to what other brothers have told me, that once COVID started, it pretty much died.
Really?
It's not dead, but I think our fraternity is like one of the few local ones that's left.
Wow.
Because there's only... I'm in New Sigma Phi.
Okay.
There are no other ones.
Just at Kean.
And that's its own thing. Right. I wanted to be in it, not for drinking and whatever, but for like the people, because I really liked who I was with. And and they have like, there's other business opportunities.
One of
the brothers he's doing some like, I don't know, some tech thing. I don't know, but
a lot of
because
money,
there's so many connections and everybody is different, but they all bond the same way. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But yeah, it's kind of, I don't want to say sad, upsetting, that's not the word, but it's interesting how, like you said, it just kind of died out after COVID.
Right.
I guess that's the case with small schools and small Greek life, especially with commuter students, where it's like, maybe I'll just go home instead of, you know, rushing a frat or joining a sorority or whatever else. But
they'll be like for the bigger organizations, they'll get, you know, way more than we would do.
Yeah.
But it's more like if you say like, you know, we'll have like a bake sale and it'll look all nice. And then like, you know, they'll see we're wearing letters or something and they'll be like, I don't want to say turned off by it, but they'll be like, I don't know if I'm interested in that. I'm just here for the food. Or, which, I mean, that helps because it raises money.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
You know, it's been, you know, not that we struggle, but it's taken a lot more effort than I would say it has in the past to recruit more people. I know there were classes that, it's a lot less people who will do it per semester now.
Yeah, and it, like you said, it's interesting. I just had no idea about that or about your fraternity, just about Greek life at Kean in general. In terms of campus traditions, you know, Kean's a fairly, I don't say newer school, but it's not like a well-established like Rutgers or even like a Rowan. You know, what are some campus traditions that you guys have, if there are any?
I'm probably not the great person to ask about this question. I can speak for like some of the fraternity things.
Yeah,
I
sure.
Guess. They have, I think, twice a semester. They have Meet the Greeks. So you go out, you meet all the Greek organizations.
Right.
That's, you know, where generally, you know, you'll see who is interested and who's not.
Yeah, makes sense.
There's Kean Day, which is when they'll get loads of tables and just clubs, organizations, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm definitely blanking on a lot.
Right, but there's no way, especially because Kean has 11,000 students, there's just no way you know about every single little tradition that every club or whatever has. Yeah.
They have so many events, I just can't keep track of them anymore.
That's always a good thing, though.
There is always something going on, I will say that.
Yeah, and there's a lot of schools, especially state schools, that there's really not so much going on. So it's good that Kean always does have at least something going on for students. And something that's really popular among students, you know, just in general, are sports games. You know, Kane's D3 school. Do people go to the football games or baseball games or basketball games, or are they just kind of for family and friends and that's it?
I've never been. I know people will go to football games, maybe basketball games. Other than that, I mean, it's not like a huge thing. I haven't seen like other people wearing like, I don't know, Kean
memorabilia and sweatshirts and whatever. Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's not like a super high up
Alabama or
right.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, you know, it's there.
If you want it, yeah.
If you want, yeah.
But it's not a way of life like it is, you know, down south. We keep touching on it. But
no.
Yeah, people at least like they go to the football games, maybe the basketball games, which again, it's always nice when something's there and it, you have the option of doing it. And I know you touched on nightlife a little bit early on, how people will go out to Rutgers or to NJIT. Is that where most people go to party, or are there, you know, bars in Union? You said,
Yeah. I don't personally know about any bars in Union.
Okay.
I
don't either. I was just asking.
But
from what other people told you. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know any. The only, like, I wouldn't say like a lot of people would. I know there are bars in Union, but I'm not like college students would
just
like
normal
go out.
People.
Now,
yeah.
I'm also not 21 and I haven't been to any of them to see them.
Right.
That's the closest I could come up with for that.
Right. And yeah, and like you said, people go to Rutgers, NJIT. So there's really like no house parties or frat parties or anything like that going on campus.
Well, there's some around, but that's, I mean, compared to like they're much, I don't want to say smaller, but I compared to NJIT or Rutgers, they're just, people would just rather go there, just because. I guess that's, they're just bigger.
Yeah.
They just have a bigger following there.
Interesting. And again, you're telling me all these things I didn't know about Kane, which is always what I what I love on these episodes, what makes them so interesting. Yeah, and Peter, as we wrap up, we've talked about a lot of really cool and important things. If you could just give me an elevator pitch on, you know, why, if I was a prospective student, why I should look at Kane, why I should go to Kane, you know, in one sentence, just describe what your experience has been like.
I'd say it's a pretty good, mostly commuter school that gets the job done and is, for the most part, no frills unless you want to be a part of an event if you want. That's the best I could do.
Yeah, no, I think that definitely accurately represents what you've described so far in this episode and from whatever other Kane students have told me that I haven't, you know, recorded an episode with. But, you know, Peter, is there any advice you have for students going to Kane or looking at schools in general? Anything that you would tell them or tell yourself looking back, you know, a couple years in the past?
Just don't forget you're going to college for an education, not to party. And this goes for any college, but just make sure you stay organized. Whether you find that out the hard way or not, just stay on top of your work and do what you need to do and the reason you're there first, and then have fun.
Yeah, I think that's great advice. I definitely agree. You go for an education and, you know, everything else kind of comes after that. But Peter, that's all I got, man. I just want to say, you know, thank you for your time and best of luck in your next 2 years at Kane.
You as well.